between four stall mats. I'll buy those cones.
Let's see. Here we go.
There's three back there that are close.
Four,
and then you're
going to
need one freestyle. You're going to go four wide behind those cones.
Okay,
that's what they walk through to drop their sandbag.
Okay. I'm the help.
Seeing stars.
For one rep?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. I'm in trouble.
It's alright, I'll run out of stars by the time the workout starts. It's to the shoulder, right?
Yeah, we did that at semis, and I failed my first rep, and Gabe was like, oh, here we go.
Gabe's
and then I
like,
let adrenaline take over.
The one nice thing about, he's in the rafters, though. Yeah. You can sense his feelings from 400
he's
feet
Spider-Man.
Away.
Spider-Man, yeah.
He feel his
he's
eyes.
He's on top of the jumbotron.
Hangs down.
It's down a page.
There's some good photos of him.
There are. The ones when he was behind the skier, like up here, just yelling down at me. And I'm like, I didn't hear a word you guys were saying. I heard the ladies next to you the whole time.
That would have been Hunter and I last year at Granite Games with Austin doing every movement unbroken and then waiting like a few minutes in between for just yelling, just what? Screaming. Last year at Granite Games, you just like do every movement unbroken and then like, whoa, Jesus. And Hunter and I are like, you gotta do the next move.
I thought it was intervals.
We're gonna start at the rig. Run over, do your pegboard. Any of the cones means feet need to pass, not like throw the sandbag over. When you get out there, you step down onto the mat, throw it. When you're in here, just make sure your feet are passed here.
see Austin, like, wow, this one's a beast. And then you fail to clear.
Like, literally jinxed him. It was 1 second later.
No speaking at the games, Dave.
Pegboards, like, I knew they would get challenging, but they were a lot harder than I thought they'd be. Like, your core gets fried, and then, like, you can't reach anymore. It's hard.
So frustrating. It's more frustrating going with him than anything else. Yeah. Like, if I was doing it by myself, I probably could have just, like, kept it. Like, it is what it is, but, like, the fact that he's staggered, he's standing there waiting for me, and then he laughs at me. It's, like, mentally... It's just frustrating to feel like something is a sticking point.
Yeah.
I mean, I know it's a good thing, like, to experience it, but, like...
Yeah.
It's a little beetle. If it was a spider, I'd flick it away. I'll let the beetle do his thing.
Thank you.
started a minute after
0-13. Nice!
Yep.
Wow. I forgot about that.
That was solid.
I said the last bit there is.
Yeah, that's where you go.
Like, when you're suffering, when you're feeling bad for yourself, that last 5-10% of the workout is just gotta be turn it off and finish.
Honestly, you put me next to people with that.
Sure, that's gonna
be adrenaline.
And then the only other thing to do what really well in the first two rounds is you come off of this, the key transition is minimizing your time before you start that first round. Right? Because once you got into that movement, you knew, okay, I'm gonna lock in and not fail a rep here. It actually gives you a little bit more time to think between your next. So, I mean, overall, really good.
Thanks.
Yeah. Gnarly way to start the day. That's definitely one of the workouts where I think we were able to do a good job of combining capacity and skill together. We want it's not higher rep, but decent volume on the pegboard with something that's gonna make them breathe really heavy, and then figuring out under that level of fatigue how to move that sandbag. One of the things that's challenging for me is I try not to coach at all during simulation workouts because they're not going to get to talk to me. I can't run out onto the floor and be like, you're on your toes, that kind of thing. So it's challenging when someone's struggling in the workout not to go out and be like, you just got to, you know, stay in your heels and be able to move the sandbag a lot better. Definitely some mental struggles in that. And when you are battling that, you just have this opportunity to either, like, it's almost like manic. Like, you can either be a rocket ship, like, because I love this and this is going great and this is how I feel, you're sort of going with that. Or it can feel like you got two sandbags out there because just the weight of everything, of the whole gym is here watching you. Now everyone else is done and they're really all watching you, that kind of thing. And Caroline obviously got super frustrated, but she talked to me after and like how quickly she comes back around to like talk about how to have the mindset better, how to move better. We're talking minutes, and in previous years, maybe it goes completely unsaid or it takes hours or days to get there. And she's pretty quickly able to like have a smirk on her face and be like, oh, I hate that it like went that way, kind of a thing. So we've made a ton of progress there. And for her, that's a number one. That's what's going to move the needle the most for her. So, we have basically the opposite workout coming up. We have a couplet of ski erg and thruster. It's gnarly. It's a real true capacity workout with some muscle endurance sprinkled in, because obviously going overhead and skiing is challenging. So that's going to be, where's your fitness at? Like, what level are you at right now? In a big way.
Austin, you got a row.
Is it only 75 pounds?
Why'd you have to say total amount?
That's why.
Honestly, it's the calories.
So are you just doing this to like, because you like to suffer, or like a time to beat? Like, what's
no, I like the. I like to, well, one, I gotta work out. Two,
it's a supportive 5,000
calorie
diet.
Two, I like to know if we hit the mark on the workouts or not.
Go ahead and help me in the bathroom.
That was one rough day, Carol. He had a meal with 9 tablespoons of fat in it. 5 tablespoons of olive oil and 4 tablespoons of bacon. Listen, yeah, when you know how to cook,
is that not normal?
Oil and butter, all right? Fuck, come on. Carol makes fun of my ski pace when we ski next
all 20 as fast as you can. You have to.
You couldn't put the bar down with this song on. Earn that mayo.
What a scene. Hunter at the bay door with Eminem. You have to run faster!
Launch the game.
Good job.
Thanks.
Transition a little bit faster than me, so you gotta do it on broken sets. Can you do 20 reps? Yeah. Have to do it on broken sets. As fast as possible. Every set. Instead, I feel like going back to 35, like it might be drastically changed if I go too big to start.
Yeah. We'll see. Who's restarting the monitors? Anybody?
Your bar after each set, and then on the final one, we don't need to run anywhere, but I do want you guys to get used to putting the bar down and getting ready. So, 3, 2, 1, go!
As bad as I thought it would be. I thought for sure I would feel more
of like a muscular like burnout just because of the volume of skiing. And then like, I mean, by the third round, you're already 60 thrusters in.
Yeah.
But it was a pretty good balance between like feeling it in my legs, feeling it in my arms, and breathing.
Yeah.
And I was actually able to use the thrusters to get my breathing back so that when I got to the skier, I wasn't like, I can't breathe and start skiing. Yeah. I could at least start skiing and then find a cadence as far as like pacing goes. But like mentally, I was going back and forth between breaking it up into two sets on the last two. Nice job, Jesse. The last two. But then I was like, that opens the window for Paige. And if she sees me break it up, she'll hold on. So it was good pacing practice for me because I'm always overestimating what I can hold. And I always end up going too fast and then going way too slow. So it was good to kind of see where the pacing was.
Yeah.
If I started at a certain number and then.
Did you feel like you were taking Mike?
Nah, he was long gone. He was long gone.
Oh, I was trying. I was like aware of everybody. I was like, oh, Carol's gaining. At the very end, I was like, let me try to cycle quicker just so I can maybe catch Austin. I'm like, it's crazy how competitive you get. It's good, it's good.
Yeah.
It made me hold on to the ball.
Being on the thrusters. And then Caroline came out, I was like 5 or 6 thrusters in, and then she beat me off the thrusters, and I still had like 5 or 6 more. And I was like, weird. Like, I must have taken a really long pause there that I didn't know about.
Your last set of thrusters looked so like effortless. Like, your face was just...
That's because I'm blacking out.
In the zone.
Mine said it's 1600.
Uh-oh. I heard somebody say like hold 13, but I was like, would you tell the ladies to hold 13?
Oh, hell
so then
no.
I'm like, I gotta go.
I knew something scared
like, you. I heard the 13, I'm like, is that for the, like, their pace or what I should be holding? I'm like, all right. And
rough.
I didn't want to blatantly push.
I, like, oh my God. I was really pushing
was like,
threshold there,
you
for
know,
sure.
I wasn't like a jump. Great job. Intention for like,
that hurt.
So I was like, F it.
But like, they were like, you know, that's one of those like, you do all the Maffetone sessions and you add, like, you accumulate hours and hours doing that stuff where like, you can learn your pace on the ski. And then like, even the thrusters, like, it's light enough where like, you can push for unbroken, even though you're really like, fiddling with that line.
What were your paces to start and like your first and second? And then
like, high 1000s. And then I was like in the 900s, and then I tailed off to like 8, 850. Like the last couple of rounds was like 8, 830.
Yeah.
I was really struggling to hold.
Yeah, it was tough.
It was my transitions too. Like that's where I lost so much time on those.
I just like the like, you guys are like rushing, like you're going hard on the transitions. Like really.
I'm glad it looked like that because I felt like I was like.
No. It looked like you were able to push start to finish, and then like there seemed to be a threshold spot for most of the people doing whatever version with like 3 minutes left, somewhere in that range.
Yeah.
That's when you're flirting with like, I want to go hard, but can my body even do it?
Yeah. Thrusters, I was able to like catch my breath during the reps, which was nice.
That's typically where I catch my breath. I get it.
There's a big thruster.
Like being able to like open my chest and like take a deep breath each time, it was very much like, on both of them, it was like the skier was like reps for me versus like, okay, just try to get the calories done. I could like count my strokes and...
Do your Maffetone work, kids.
They're doing like a clean and jerk ladder. I'm gonna do the double under snatch ladder that they did yesterday. I really thought I was gonna come after work and they were doing that one, but they were doing the burpee one.
One more. Little clean and jerk platform every 2.5 minutes until failure. One clean and jerk at progressing weights. The women start at 185 and go up to 195, 205, then it's just fives until you fail. We do have the tie break like they do at the games. So if any of them tie, they have to do 5 clean and jerks for time at 175.
Ooh.
Yeah.
The legs.
Oh,
in a black Marquis. Made by your vintage. I can make you lose your sleep. You millionaires will just eat grand old scrambling. Now pass the champagne to the champion. My niggas get money, get money, get money. Then my kids say play. Good stuff, make the drum line like champagne. Your Balenciaga jacket lining. You and your bitch income combining. Send a Lorraine Schwartz diamond mining. Fine. I came up with Enzo drippers. So you got to understand it's a different kind. Critics, he's out of his mind. Haters, he's out of his mind.
Good job.
Go, Austin.